What's up, guys? So we've already talked about creating links, relative versus absolute. So now let's talk about the final link in our series, which is the link within the page itself. Let's say you have a long page. So I added another article down here, blah, 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 blah. And at the bottom, there's this link here that says link to top of page. And I want that when we click on it, I want it to take us up to the top. This, of course, is useful when you have a lot of content on your pages, or if at the top you want it to jump to a specific location on the site. So when we're linking with inside the document, we still use the ahref element. But this time, instead of pointing it to a link, we're going to point it to an ID. So let me show you how that works. Down here in our HTML, we have our paragraph, and here's my blah, blah, blah paragraph. And beneath that, I have the link to the top of the page. All I have to do is wrap this in an ahref. And then I'm going to equal. And then this time, instead of a page or an absolute link, I'm going to just put pound ID and then close it out in a quote. I know, seems odd. But watch this go to work. Then I'm going to wrap what I want to be the link. So link to top of page, and close out that link tag with a closing A. So now that I've done that down here, nope, missing my closing bracket. There we go. Now I need to obviously add this ID up here towards the top, wherever I want it to jump to. So in my HTML, I want it to jump up to the top, so let's go ahead and add it. We'll just add it to our navigation here. So I'm going to put ID equals ID. And we could have called it whatever we wanted. I could have called it top. The only thing with IDs is that they do have to be unique, so I can't use the ID again. But that will work for this example. And let's go ahead and save it. Go back to our web page here. I'm going to refresh. And when we scroll down, now when I click on it, it takes me to the top. Very cool, right? Notice that down here, the link is not styled the same as the rest. That's because in our HTML and CSS document, all of those styles were assigned to the navigation link only. So if I want to, I can add another set of styles to style that link. Obviously with a white background, I wouldn't want it to be a white link, but I could remove the underline if I want. Oh, the possibilities. And that's it for this video, a nice short one for you. The next series, we're going to talk about inserting images into our site, which will be super fun. If you're enjoying these videos, be sure to subscribe. So until then, I will catch you later.